All the teachers are standing out, like, telling everyone where to go. It's funny.
You know, if it hasn't happened yet, it will later this week. It is back to school time for Central Iowa kids. So what's new at school this year? Plenty. Two high schools that were visited today by this lady.
That's right. Two bond referendums paid for big, brand new, beautiful buildings. Our tours of them are today's top story.
Principal Chuck Bredlow has a lot to smile about.
Smile.
Welcoming students back.
Like the freshmen look really scared.
In a huge new school.
It's one of the largest in the state.
His pride and joy here at the gymnasium, which can seat 4,000.
We can put up 9 volleyball courts. We have an indoor track. We have a fitness center. We have video boards.
State-of-the-art technology connects a video projection system throughout the building.
They all connect to each other, so you can show anything anywhere in the building, whether it be on the video board in the gym, the big screens in the commons area, or here on any one of those. Every teacher has the projector unit in their classrooms.
And every classroom is cooled by a geothermal system.
We've never had air before that worked in the whole building, so our kids are enjoying today very much.
Students at Urbandale High are also enjoying their new school, twice the size of the old.
It's really new and nice, and I don't know, it's huge.
It's not as big as Southeast Polk, of course, but then we're not as big as Southeast Polk, but this facility, in my mind, has got to be one of the best facilities in the state right now.
Principal Richard Hutchinson loves the library.
All furniture we have is movable.
The cafeteria has cozy booths. It boasts a performing arts center, and an intercom security system now locks the doors at 8 a.m.
Show me your ID and I'll let you in. Thank you.
At both high schools, as kids learn their way around,
it kind of makes you want to go to school.
They say they are more eager to learn within the new walls.
Both are beautiful schools. The schools have been under construction for 3 years. In 2006, voters passed Southeast Polk's $60 million bond referendum for the new high school and swimming pool, and a $29 million bond referendum for the high school in